Firebird. That's cool.
Come on, hop in.
Listen to it.
That tire's done.
You're about to lose it. You're about to lose it. Woo! Really am surprised it did as well as it did.
Yeah. I've looked at the market for convertible Firebirds, and if done right, they're going for $40,000 to $75,000. Sometimes, if you can get a Firebird built just right, it can fetch upwards of six figures. This one's easy cash so long as we get it done quick and efficient. So I've got all the parts to make it badass already on the way. We'll replace the motor with a 467 cubic inch monster. And to get all that horsepower to the ground, we'll slap on a 5-speed Silver Sport transmission and a quick performance rear end. For the right ride, let's go with a new suspension and the stopping power of Wilwood brakes. For sure it needs big, meaty tires on fresh rims, but let's get to it. 10 days, take it apart, put it back together, and let's sell it.
Hey, one more thing. How much money do we get to work with?
Just do it.
I heard him say 25, 30 grand.
Yeah. I'll get in it.
I'll admit, that 67 Firebird convertible was never my dream car. It did have a little more power than I expected, but the car's rough, man. It is in bad shape, and it's got a terrible stance. This one has me worrying a little bit. This car has a few signs that are showing that there might be some bigger problems.
It was like a slow donut. It's like so slow.
Right now, let's just get the trim, interior, drivetrain out of it, and then we'll give it to the guys in the body shop, you guys, with a suspension on it. Let's go.
We're on a 10-day deadline to knock the ugly off the 67 Firebird and build it into a car with some gas monkey style. Richard pre-ordered all the parts, from a crate motor to the new suspension, so we can get this bad boy done on time.
See, a guy that carries a flat spare tire is not a smart man.
What's your over and under on skull count? On
I say we got. I say you got 12. You said 13, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna say.
I'm gonna shoot one low just because.
Four skulls on the wheels. We had our door lock skull.
That's right.
Six.
Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. I'm money.
Please give me some skulls on them license plates back there.
Nope, they're spikes.
Nope, negative.
So what do I win, Mike?
You win a date with Jeremy.
You're buying.
Another one?
Yeah. I'm starting to understand Sue when she says Richard always brings me junk.
Yeah.
I feel like he does that to us, too.
I'm starting to agree with that a lot more. First red flag of the day was when we got the car in position to tear it down, the passenger door wouldn't open.
Yeah,
it just stopped working. Just fine, and all of a sudden, now it doesn't work.
I think someone sat on the lock getting in it.
Bet the linkage.
This door's broke here, too, and broke here.
And it's usually something like that, and it's a snowball effect.
I think these quarters are too far forward.
And you're positive quarters have been put in?
No, I'm not positive. That's what I'm saying.
I have no idea.
I can look inside. They may be original, Mike, because I got rust here.
The trunk pan is not, and there's fiberglass all over
the back. Yeah, the whole bottom is fiberglass.
Well, then it's been hacked up then. And sure enough, as we got the car further apart, we started finding signs.
I can already tell you, it looks like there's been floor pan put in.
And it's a convertible, so if they don't do
it
right.
That's factory, though. All this is factory.
Yeah, but this isn't.
No, yeah. And when we peeled the carpet back, we found that the entire floor of the car had been cut out and really poorly welded back on top of it.
If they didn't do it correctly, that body could talk to them. Being a convertible like that, you don't have roof structure, so really all of it relies on your floor. And if they just threw these pans in and over time that car had sagged like this, could be an issue why we're having a problem with our doors fitting.
We can't make a door fit in a hole that's an inch too short, front to back.
Let's roll it to the lift.
This puts up a huge red flag for us right now, because if we go to all this work and we still can't make all those pieces fit without having to cut the car apart, then it's a wasted project.
Oh, look at this. It's all gone. I mean, the whole floor's coming out of it.
That's the worst floor I've ever seen in a car. You see this?
Yeah, it's terrible.
Just look at the jagged metal. They just literally chopped it and then laid the other floor on top of it. They didn't even take the old floor out. Richard could have called one of us up to come look at it. He was just a few miles away, but he has a history of buying crap when he doesn't have a mechanic with him.
Let me guess. Rust.
Oh, it's a little bigger than rust this time. I mean, rust doesn't scare me. You know, we knew what we were getting into with this car. It's pretty rough anyway.
There's just no car left.
The rail connectors are the only thing holding the car together. We cannot ethically put this car back together.
You couldn't attach anything to another thing.
No, it has to all be cut out.
It's a bad one.
It's not just rust damage. Entire sections of the floor are missing. Worse than that, the frame of the car's rod is so bad that it's tacoing. It's literally folding up on itself. On a convertible, you have no roof structure. So they usually what they do is they'll stiffen the frame and the chassis and the floor. Well, on this one, it was so rotted out that the car's actually, like, say this is the front and this is the back, it's actually starting to fold like this because the structure's gone.
We just found out that the car that I have is completely full of rust. It looks like Swiss cheese. I've got to find another car to see if we can even get one bought at a satisfactory price that we can build, because we've got all the parts already on order. It looks like most of the Firebirds that I'm finding out there for sale are either rusty as this one or already finished. I've already got all the parts coming, and I need a car to build. And Pontiac parts are so specific to the car that what am I going to do with them if I don't have a 67 to put them in? Russell gives me a call because he's out gallivanting around the Northeast, and I'm here in Texas sweating it out, trying to figure out what we're going to do with this Firebird.
We have opened Pandora's box.
What? The 67 Firebird?
I mean, this is probably the worst car we've ever had at Gas Monkey.
That's saying a lot.
I got to figure out what I'm going to do now. I don't know where I'm at right now. I'm scouring the nation right now for one.
Well, as long as I have you, you're okay. I'll keep an eye out for a convertible Firebird. Chin up, little guy. That's why I'm your fixer, right?
Just don't spend more than 20 or 22 grand on it.
Okay, sayonara, sucker.
I got the door.
What an ass whipping.
Look at the rust even in the trim work, man. This thing is junk.
This thing's hog shit.
It's awful quiet in here.
Yeah, we're contemplating this rust bucket.
I know, we already said we'd kick it, but I got Russell trying to find one.
These cars are expensive?
They're a little more expensive than I want to spend, considering we're trashing this one.
Uh-oh.
Who is this? Well, look at that.
How's that for?
Well, there you go. That's the real car.
How's that for service? If it looks good underneath, then I'm happy.
Well, aren't you just the
aren't you timely?
The savior for this. We were just talking about how bad
I knew something
was
up when you weren't answering my phone calls.
Well, it's hard to hear anything with the top down, and it's a longer drive than I thought it was going to be. But you said you needed one because that thing was a mess.
So you drove us in from New York?
Yeah, baby.
What's amazing is your hair is still perfect.
It actually is. I was like this most of the way.
Got it.
Hey, this is a different hood and stuff. Still same car though, right?
Yeah, I mean same body,
car. Same year.
What'd I buy this for?
25 for it to be in the condition it's in.
Jesus.
But you're not finding one like this, especially with what you guys have in mind on it.
Richard had paid what I thought was too much for the white car. Now he's having to kick out 25 grand for the red car, which seems like a lot of money, but this is a really solid car. It runs, drives, obviously. You know, it's just made a 1,500-mile trek. Now we have a parts car, and we have a buildable car. And for us, that's the ideal situation to build what we want.
We have to start all over with this Firebird. With everything I've spent on this project, I'm down 35 grand before we even touched it. But convertibles are always popular, and this will be a high-powered cruiser like none other. All the cool stuff I already ordered, that all stays. Never mind the copper, painted a sexy gunmetal gray. I originally gave the guys 10 days on the build, but I reset the clock and still gave the monkeys 10 whole days to build it. They better move it. I'll sell that, you know, for $5,000-$6,000. Put the money back in the bank, and off we go.
Hey, that works. Yeah. Cool.
Killer. Right, I can sell these wheels. Good job, man.
Hey, man, thanks. Woo! We need to go over some toll receipts and some gas receipts. It took a little bit to get down here.
We got a window of sunshine. We need to get this thing loaded. It might be a brief one, so we're going to try to go over as quickly as possible. We're days behind on the Firebird build, and Richard was not happy when I told him I can't control the weather. We ran into a lot of weather problems last week in Dallas that put our Firebird way behind.
This looks so sketchy.
As far as I know, I built a garage and I put a roof on it, and Jason's telling me there's a weather delay. I mean, this isn't baseball.
Rain's coming, we gotta hurry.
Between the two Firebirds and enough parts to build both of them, I'm at least $35,000 into this project with nothing to show for it.
Okay, guys, we'll be back in a minute.
I tell them which way the wind blows around here, and if these guys don't get this Firebird done on time, the forecast is gonna be stormy overcast with a chance of firing. Tick tock.